Welcome to another Power BI desktop tutorial. Today we will create a dashboard showing airports of the world, using maps, pie charts, column charts, and scatter charts. We will use the World Airport Dataset to create a dashboard in Power BI desktop. Link to the dataset is provided in the description below. To download the data, you need to log in first. We will use our Google ID to log into the server. We need to choose a profile name between 6 and 20 characters to continue. Press Next to continue. Agree to the privacy and terms. Now you can go ahead and download the data set using the download button at the top right corner. This will download data in zip file to your hard drive. We will extract the data set to use it in our Power BI dashboard. Provide the address where you want to extract the data. Now press the extract button to extract the file. There are over 75,000 records in the data set. There are a number of columns that can be used to create visuals. For example, we can show number of airports by airport type. We can also analyze airports by their elevation. We can use the GPS coordinates and the location information to show airports on a map. We can also show number of airports by scheduled service. Finally, we can analyze the runways by length, width, and lighting. To import data from CSV, go to the Get Data menu and select CSV. Select the CSV file and press Open. Wait for Power BI to connect to the data set. If you don't want to make any changes, just press the load button. Wait for the Power BI desktop to import the data from CSV file. Once the data is loaded, all the fields will appear in the data area, which you can use to create visuals. We will start our dashboard by creating a title using the text box visual. The first visual that we will create will be a map showing countries with number of airports. We will insert the ISO country field into our dashboard. This will automatically create a map visual. To display the number of airports in each country using bubble size, we will use the airport identification field as count. Let's rename the file as number of airports. Change the ISO country field to country. Our map visual is now complete. We will create a duplicate of the map visual to display each airport on the map. To create this visual, we will use the GPS coordinates of airports. GPS coordinates are available in the form of longitude and latitude. We will remove the bubble size field, as we are displaying the individual airports. We can use the number of airports by country visual to filter the data in the other map and display airports of a specific country. We will decrease the size of bubble as well, to make the chart more visually attractive and readable. Let's change the names of latitude and longitude fields, for better visualization. We will add a pie chart to our dashboard, to display number of airport by lighted runways. We will add the airport identification, as count, in the values area. The runways lighted fields, will be added to the legend area. Now we can see the number of airports with runways lighted, not lighted, and no data. We will create a duplicate pie chart, using existing pie chart. Now, we will replace the lighted runways field, with the scheduled service field, to display number of airports by scheduled service. To display the number of airports by type, we will add a column chart. We will add the type field, to the x-axis of the column chart. And the airport identification field, to the y-axis of the column chart, as count. Let's rename the y-axis field, to number of airports. To display number of airports by elevation, we will add a column chart to our dashboard. However, we want to display elevation in bins, which we will create using DAX. Let's create a new column named elevation. Here we will use if function, to define bins of below 0 feet, 0 to 500, 500 to 1000, 1000 to 2000. 2,000 to 5,000, and above 5,000 feet. To keep the nested if function simple, we will use the next line. We will keep copying the existing if function to next line, and make small changes to create a new bin. Press the Alt plus Enter to move to next line. Create a new bin for airports having elevation of 500 to 1000 feet. Create a new bin for airports having elevation of 1000 to 2000 feet. Create another bin for airports having elevation of 2,000 to 5,000 feet. All the remaining airports should have the elevation of over 5,000 feet. The DAX-based column is now ready. Now we can use this column to create a visual showing number of airports by their elevation. We will add the elevation field that we created using DAX to the x-axis of our column chart. And our chart is now showing number of airports by elevation in defined bins. Finally, we will display airports by the length and width of their runways. We will use a scatter chart to display this information. We will add the runway length field to the x-axis and the width field to the y-axis. Finally, we will add the name of the airport to the values area. Our dashboard is now complete. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials and updates.